Okay, back to Pam. What's going on?
Well, Dr. Cloud, I need some of your wisdom, some words of advice here. I've been married for 3 years, and yeah. I'm a fun, outgoing, bubbly person. But let me tell you, since I've been married, I have turned into one witchy woman. I am critical. I'm judgmental. I don't like who I have become. I am not proud to say any of this, but I.
Well, I got to tell you one thing, Pam, become. And I've said this before on this program. Right now, you're one of my favorite people in the world. And what I mean by that is, you know, and I say this a lot, I'm going to say it again, somebody hadn't heard me say it, is a psychologist feels like they won the lottery when somebody comes in and says, I have this problem, and it's because I'm like this, instead of, I have this problem, and they're blaming everybody else. Now, I know there's bad people in the world, but when you say, I've got this problem, I've become a witchy woman, you have really, really opened the door to, this thing is fixable, because you're owning it, and God bless you for that. So you get Caller of the Day Award.
Well, I certainly would not get Wife of the Year or the Day Award, I promise you.
Well, let me ask you a question. Would your husband agree with you?
He would probably say that my delivery could be different.
That your delivery what?
Could be different, the way I deliver to say, because I don't hold things back.
Okay, great. That's wonderful. But would he agree with what you said? He would say, yeah, you could improve the delivery. But would he call me and say, I don't know what happened, I'm married to a witch? Would he say that?
No, he would not say that.
Okay, so there's a little bit of a difference of how you're evaluating yourself and how he's experiencing you, or at least his honesty about it.
Exactly. He would tell you I can be critical.
All right. Well, so let's hop into it. What do you do, and how can I help you?
I don't want to stay a witchy woman. I don't want to be this person, and I feel like if I stay in my marriage, even when I put out the boundaries, like, okay, look, this isn't working for me. You see my pain. You don't want to fix it. What do I do? I know that you said and never go back. You don't go back if things aren't changing.
Well, I'm gonna give you the principle, and then you have to go. You know, you got to talk to your counselor as you're doing and all that and figure it out. But here's the thing, that the witchiness that you're calling it, because you're feeling powerless, right?
Completely.
You're feeling helpless. You're feeling helpless because all the need to change and the impetus to change and the energy for change is coming from you. And it doesn't sound like there's a lot from him. So what I would want to do is if you were sitting before me, I would want to know directly with him, you know, tell me what you want here, okay? Because if you want her and you want to make this work, then A, B, and C is going to have to change because she's going to keep living down the street. And I would also, until you change, and we got to get a specific plan, and you've got to show that you're going to work that plan, hubby, and, you know, whatever we got to do from his side of the equation. But there's something going on in here that is allowing him to have this. How is he getting away with this, for lack of a better word? I mean, how much access does he have? What's rewarding him to make this okay? You may be living separately, but somehow he's probably still getting some goodies out of this somewhere. And I don't know what the boundaries are, but boundaries have got to have, you know, when you get to this far into it, boundaries have got to have very, 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 or I should say this, boundaries have got to have the appropriate level of consequences. So the person that really it's important for them to begin to change feels enough motivation to do something about that. And if all you're doing is nagging him, he's deaf to that. He's proven that.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So what he's got to feel is, look, here's what you and the counselor to Joey, here's what you've got to do in order to get the goodies from her that you're wanting to have. Okay. And one of those would be to move back in. One of those would be, you know, whatever level of relationship y'all have. But it sounds like this has been such a hybrid, a separation for 5 months without a plan, right? He was letting that go. I mean, if your wife moves out, generally you kind of go, crap, I need to do something about this, right? Well, something didn't happen, or y'all were working on it just together. But I would want to get very, very specific. And I would say, here's what I need to have happen before A, B, C, or D, whatever interaction he gets to have with you. I don't know what it is, but I would line up the boundaries to hold them until we see some change in him. And that way, you're not going to be critical. You don't have anything to be critical about. We're just watching him. He's going to judge himself by seeing if he steps up and does what's required of him. So I would look at it that way.
Thank you.
Instead of this, you've been in a tug of war with him, right? It's this battle back and forth. And that's terrible. And you're not being heard. So what has to happen is, here's what I've got to see change. And you and Dr. So-and-so, give us a plan here. Tell him what he's got to do that, other than just say, okay, I'm going to be different. He's got to do some specific steps. And when I see that, I'll give you this. We will have this. But until we see that, I'm going to sit back and wait. And he begins to feel this is costing him. Now, I also, I mean, conflict avoidant, well, you avoid conflict. Yeah, but look at the conflict you're reaping, unless you're not reaping any, other than a naggy wife, which a lot of guys can go deaf to, so that help. Okay.